Bettina.
Yes, I'll be there.
What's your Jimmy's name again?
Django.
Django. Bettina Sugar, could you take Django there and take him around the grounds here and show him all the pretty stuff?
As you please, be there.
Oh, Mr. Bennett, I must remind you, Django is a free man. He cannot be treated like a slave. Within the bounds of good taste, he must be treated as an extension of myself.
Understood, Schultz. Bettina Sugar?
Yes, ma'am.
Django isn't a slave. Django is a free man, you understand? You can't treat him like any of the other niggas around here because he ain't like any of the other niggas around here. You got it?
You want I should treat him like white folks?
No. That's not what I said.
Then I don't know what you want, Big Daddy.
Yes, I can see that. What's the name of that Peckerwood boy from town that works with the glass? His mama work over at the lumber yard.
Oh, you mean Jerry?
That's the boy's name, Jerry. You know Jerry, don't you, Sugar?
Yes, and Big Daddy.
Well, that's it then. You just treat him like you would Jerry.
That house we just left from is the big house. Big Daddy call it that because it's big. That there is the pantry. That's where Big Daddy hang all his dead meat. Poor little squirrels. What you do for your master?
Didn't you hear him tell you ain't no slave?
So you really free?
Yes, I was free.
You mean you want to dress like that?
Tina, I need to ask you something.
What you want?
I'm looking for three white men. Three brothers, overseers. The name is Brittle. You know him?
Brittle?
Yes, Brittle. John Brittle, Ellis Brittle, Roger Brittle. Sometimes called Little Raj.
I don't know them.
They could be using a different name. They would have come to the plantation this past year.
You mean the Schaefers?
Maybe. Three brothers?
Uh-huh.
They here?
Uh-huh.
Could you point one of them out to me?
Well, one's over in that field.
Oh, man, Karuka ain't gonna appreciate this. Now, she working the house, John. You can mess her skin up, and you gonna mess up. She ain't gonna be worth nothing. She ain't gonna be worth the damn thing. Now, your father say.
Felt like the weight of the world was on my shoulder.
I told you that I was one that made a do it.
You ready?
She the one out for me. If anybody should be getting whooped now, it should be me. It should be me, John. I've been here long enough. You know me. You know me a long time now.
Facing the fear that the truth I discovered.
You know, Master, no Karuka ain't gonna appreciate this. She's a house slave. She a house slave. She can't walk out. That's all we need, John.
I like the way you beg, boy.
Is that who you was looking for?
Yep. Where the other two at?
They by the stable, punishing little Jody for breaking eggs.
They whipping little Jody? Point me in that direction.
You go to that tree and keep going that away.
Go get that white man I came here with.
Come on now. Come on, Burley. Come on. Get you set up.
And the Lord said, the fear of ye and the dread of ye shall be on every beast of the earth.
You better give me that arm! You better give me that arm!
Okay, she ready!
And after this, we'll see if you break eggs again.
John Brittle!
Remember me? I like the way you die, boy.
God damn son of a bitch!
See something?
Where they?
That's Big John. That's Little Raj.
Where's Ellis?
He's the one hightailing it across that field right now.
Sure that's him?
Yeah.
Positive?
I don't know.
You don't know if you're positive?
I don't know what positive means.
It means you're sure?
Yes.
Yes what?
Yes, I'm sure that's Ellis Brittle. I'm positive he dead.
Django! Everybody calm down. We mean no one else any harm.
Who are you two jokers?
I am Dr. King Schultz, a legal representative of the criminal justice system of the United States of America. The man to my left is Django Freeman. He's my deputy. In my pocket is a warrant signed by Circuit Court Judge Henry Allen Laudermilk of Austin, Texas, for the arrest and capture, dead or alive, of John Brittle, Roger Brittle, and Ellis Brittle.
They're going by the name Schaefer.
You know them by the name of Schaefer, but the butcher's real name was Brittle. These are wanted men. The law wants them for murder. Now, I reiterate, the warrant states dead or alive. So when Mr. Freeman and myself executed these men on site, we were operating within our legal boundaries. I realize passions are high, but I must warn you, the penalty for taking deadly force against an officer of the court in the performance of his duty is you'll be hung by the neck until you're dead. Now, may I please remove the warrant from my pocket so you may examine it?
Give me. Satisfied? May I have that back, please?
Get off my land.